the National Program for Control of Blindness is a 100% centrally sponsored program and was launched in 1976 with the goal of reducing the prevalence of blindness from 1.4% to 0.3%. The latest survey was held in 2006 and 7, and according to that survey, the prevalence was found to be 1%. The prevalence of blindness was 1%. Various 5-year plans following the launch of program have included activities which are targeted towards achieving the goal of reducing the prevalence of blindness to 0.3% by 2020. What do we call as blindness? When do we call a person as blind? Under the national program, blindness has been defined at a higher cutoff than what WHO has defined. The definition under our national program is inability of a person to count fingers from a distance of 6 meters, which is equivalent of 20 feet. And the technical definition under the program is a vision of 6 by 60 or less with the best possible spectacle correction. The WHO, on the other hand, has set a lower cutoff, and the WHO defines blindness at the level of a vision 3 by 60 or inability to count fingers at a distance of 3 meters, equivalent of 10 feet. The objectives of the National Program for Control of Blindness. 1. To reduce the backlog of avoidable blindness. We have already discussed the concept of avoidable blindness in our lecture on blindness. To reduce the amount of already present avoidable blindness. How to do it? By identification of the avoidable blind and treatment of those who can be treated at all the 3 levels of eye care, that is primary, secondary and tertiary levels. We have already discussed the services available at the primary, secondary and tertiary level of eye care in the lecture on blindness. 2. To develop comprehensive eye care facilities in every district. Comprehensive means not just curative but also preventive. For example, to treat trichiasis in time before it has caused blindness. So would be comprehensive eye care facilities for control of blindness. Upgradation of the regional institutes of ophthalmology so that they become centers of excellence in ophthalmology and all its subspecialities. To improve the quality of the already existing infrastructure at all the 3 levels of eye care so that the quality of service delivery improves tremendously. To enhance the awareness of the community so that people know when to seek eye care and that they can get rid of their visual impairment. To encourage research for prevention of blindness, to find out new methods for prevention and treatment of blindness. And to secure participation of voluntary organizations and private practitioners for eye care so that the coverage is increased. What are the strategies which are planned so as to achieve the objectives which were listed earlier? 1 is to continue the emphasis on free cataract surgeries, because cataract still is the cause for a large percentage of blindness in our country, through the government healthcare system and through NGOs and private sectors. Next, to make the program comprehensive, that is by including treatment for other causes of blindness too, like diabetic retinopathy, glaucoma, corneal blindness, sophisticated surgeries like vitreoretinal surgeries, etc. So as to address the remaining causes of avoidable blindness also. Active screening of population above 50 years of age for cataract. and those found positive would be treated. Screening of children for refractive errors, because refractive errors also form an important cause of preventable blindness or treatable blindness. Coverage of areas which are underserved with eye care services. Improving the coverage. Capacity building, that is improving the number of eye care providers and improving the quality of their skill. Information, education, communication, IEC activities for community to improve their awareness regarding the need for eye care, when to seek eye care and where to seek eye care from, and that some of the visually impaired can get rid of the visual impairment also. Strengthening the Regional Institute of Ophthalmology and the ophthalmology sections of medical colleges, the departments of ophthalmology, to be improved with improved infrastructure, facilities and staff. Improving the eye care facilities in district hospital level also by upgrading the present infrastructure and employing more staff on contract. More emphasis on primary eye care and establish vision centers on all PHCs. The vision centers will act as primary eye care centers. The importance of primary eye care is that a disease treated early, a potential cause of blindness, if treated early, can prevent blindness altogether. For example, trachoma. And at the onset of trachoma, it can be easily cured with a 5 rupee ointment, eye ointment. Whereas if it is allowed left untreated, if it is left untreated, it can lead to complications which can cause blindness, which can only be treated by corneal transplant, which is very high in price and as well as waiting for a donated cornea. Hence, the emphasis on primary eye care, and that a vision center should be made available at all the primary health centers. And creating mobile ophthalmic units for providing high quality eye care facilities and treatment in far-flung areas. The organizational structure of the National Program for Control of Blindness. It is a 100% centrally sponsored program, and the administrative unit at the central level is the ophthalmology section under the Directorate General of Health Services. At the level of the states, the state ophthalmic cells were established, and at the district level, district blindness control societies were established, which were finally responsible for delivery of the eye care services within the district. At the state level, it was seen that the state ophthalmic cell was doing similar work as the state blindness society. Hence, the ophthalmic cell was merged with the state blindness society to avoid this duplication of work. With the advent of NRHM, state health societies have been established at the state level. Now, the state blindness cell has also been merged with the state health societies. Now it functions as a blindness division within each health society. Similarly, at the district level, district health societies have been established at the district level under NRHM, and the district blindness control societies has been merged with the district health society as a section of the district health society. The blindness section under the district health society provides the services for eye care. These services are provided at primary, secondary and tertiary levels. The services offered at various levels have been discussed in the lecture on blindness. The primary level services are provided by the sub-district hospitals, CHCs, upgraded PHCs and the mobile units. These mobile units are specially handy for providing services in the underserved areas and increase accessibility to eye services to remote areas. The mobile unit consists of a vehicle, an ophthalmic surgeon and paramedical staff. Most of the cataract surgeries in rural areas are conducted through these mobile units. Basic unit from where these mobile units operate. At the secondary level, the services are provided by the district and NGO hospitals. Surgeries like cataract, like entropion, are provided at this level. The tertiary level eye care, that is the more sophisticated procedures, is provided by the regional institutes of ophthalmology and the ophthalmology department of medical colleges within the district. State health societies have been constituted under the National Rural Health Mission, and the details would be discussed in the lecture on NRHM. Functions of the Blindness Division of State Health Society. The primary purpose is to plan, implement and monitor the blindness control activities in the state, in all the districts of the state, and as per the directions of the central government, that is the ophthalmology section of NPCB. The functions include to coordinate and monitor all the district health societies among each other, to procure funds and equipment for eye care and monitor their use at the district level, to involve NGOs and private practitioners of the state in providing free or subsidized eye care, to promote eye donation in the state and monitor the collection and utilization of the eyes collected. District health societies have been constituted under NRHM. The details of the society would be discussed in the lecture on NRHM. Here it suffices to know that it has a maximum of 15 members. The chairman is the district collector, and the technical advisor of the district health society is the chief ophthalmic surgeon of the district hospital in that district. These are the other members of the district health society. The functions of district health societies, which are under the National Program for Blindness Control. The primary purpose of district health society, the blindness section, is to implement and monitor the blindness control activity within the district. These include to assess the magnitude of the problem of blindness in the district, to organize screening camps for cataract, and to organize transportation and free surgery for those requiring the cataract surgery, to train community level workers in eye care, to involve voluntary and private hospitals providing eye care services in the district within the program, to organize screening of school children for detection of refractive errors and other eye problems, and provide free glasses to poor children, to promote eye donation and monitor the utilization of the donated eyes. The school eye screening component of the national program. The recommended procedure is that teachers are trained for screening the student for possible presence of refractive errors. Children who are suspected to have refractive errors by the teachers are seen by the ophthalmic assistants, and the refraction is done. Corrective spectacles are prescribed, which are provided free for persons below poverty line. Collection and utilization of the donated eyes under the program. Eye donation fortnight is organized from 25th of August to 8th September each year. Voluntary organizations such as Lions International, Rotary International and their branches, they organize eye camps in remote, rural and urban areas as per the government guidelines. What is the assistance that WHO has provided for prevention of blindness in the country? WHO sponsors intra-country fellowships in sophisticated eye surgeries like cornea transplantation, vitreoretinal surgery, use of lasers in ophthalmology and pediatric ophthalmology. WHO conducted a pilot survey on childhood blindness in Delhi. It helps in organizing the training in the district program management, that is management of program at the district level. It conducted a study on the situational analysis of eye care infrastructure and human resources in India, that is what is infrastructure and how many resources are there, human resources, how many specialists are there, are they sufficient or not. WHO organizes high quality workshops in eye care for the faculty of medical colleges. And development of plan of action. It developed the plan of action for Vision 2020, the Right to Sight Initiative. Vision 2020, the Right to Sight. This is a global initiative by WHO to the member countries, and the aim is to reduce the avoidable blindness by 2020. The target diseases under the initiative are cataract, refractive errors, glaucoma, diabetic retinopathy. Under the initiative of Vision 2020, the Right to Sight, it is aimed to improve human resource, infrastructure and technology development at various levels of the system for prevention and control of blindness. Vision 2020 proposes a four-tier structure, which includes at the top 20 centers of excellence, 200 training centers, below them 2,000 service centers, and at the primary level 20,000 vision centers by 2020 with full personnel and equipment to provide primary, secondary and tertiary care, eye care. This is the pyramid of the infrastructure visualized under Vision 2020, the Right to Sight. The primary level care would be provided by 20,000 primary level vision centers, and the primary level care would include refraction and the appropriate glass prescription of glasses, primary eye care, school eye screening programs, screening and referral services to the higher level. At the secondary level, 2,000 service centers are to be established, which will provide secondary level eye care like cataract surgery, other common eye surgeries, facilities for refraction and referral services to the tertiary center if required. The tertiary level is visualized to be provided by the 200 training centers and 20 centers of excellence. At the tertiary, eye care would be provided by the training centers, training and continued medical education. In the centers of excellence, professional leadership, strategy development for furthering the control activities and continued medical education, laying down standards, quality assurance for the lower levels, and research for newer methods of control of blindness and visual impairment in these centers of excellence. Universal Eye Health, a Global Action Plan 2014 to 2019. This is an action plan by WHO with a vision of a world in which nobody is needlessly visually impaired. That is, those who have visual impairment due to cataract should get cataract surgery and get normal vision, and other causes which can be treated should be treated. Those where the blindness could have been prevented should have been prevented. That is, there should not be any blindness due to trachoma, due to vitamin deficiency, and a world where those who have a vision loss which could not be avoided, they can achieve their full potential. And a world where everyone has, there's a universal access to comprehensive eye care services. Universal access means each and everybody, even those living in remote areas, have an access to eye care services. And comprehensive eye care means all the services, primary, secondary and tertiary level eye care services are to be provided to all. WHO estimates that if only two major causes of blindness can be controlled, 2/3 of the visually impaired can regain good sight, and these are cataract and refractive errors. The basis of the new action plan is that reduction of avoidable blindness depends not only on specific eye care services only, but also on other sectors like RCS, reproductive and child health, where immunization against rubella can prevent congenital cataract, against measles, can prevent measles which precipitates vitamin E deficiency to the level that keratomalacia can occur. Nutrition is provided, a good nourished, well-nourished child is least likely to have vitamin E deficiency leading to blindness. Prematurity is properly managed so as to prevent retinopathy of prematurity. So these fall under the purview of RCH. Safe water and basic sanitation would prevent communicable diseases of the eye which can be blinding, for example trachoma and other diseases. Also, eye health is influenced by the control of non-communicable diseases like diabetes mellitus, hypertension, because these lead to retinopathy. Then control of communicable diseases, again trachoma. Then geriatric health programs have to incorporate eye care, because 80% of avoidable blindness is in geriatric age group only. Hence, eye care services can be strengthened by integrating into primary health care. Primary health care means when all the services are provided at the primary center, which includes RCA services, suggestions for safe water and basic sanitation, control of non-communicable diseases, control of communicable diseases, and eye care disease services are provided at the primary health center itself. WHO has suggested three categories of indicators for helping the member countries to assess if the universal eye health carried out by them is adequate or not. These indicators are prevalence of visual impairment and causes of visual impairment. Target has been set as reduction of avoidable blindness by 25% by 2019. 25% of what? 25% of the levels which were there in 2010 in the country itself. Hence, the target would be different for each country depending upon the prevalence in 2010. Second indicator is the number of eye care personnel. So each country can set a target value and to see whether they achieve it or not. The third are indicators of cataract surgical service delivery. Is cataract surgery service adequate or not? These are cataract surgical rate, that is number of cataract surgeries performed per million population in 1 year. And second is cataract surgical coverage, that is number of individuals with bilateral cataract who have received cataract surgery on at least one eye.